Hello and welcome to Edupedia World. In this tutorial, we'll be studying about another OOPS concept in detail, which is inheritance in Java. So let's see how inheritance is implemented in Java. Well, in simple words, inheritance is a way to define new a class using classes which have already been defined. That means inheritance is the capability of a class to use the properties and methods of another class while adding its own functionality. So there is an example where there is a base class and it is having some data members and member function. Then there would be another class which could implement or extend that class. That means it is inheriting that class. Now, if it is inheriting that class, that means it could use or reuse its properties and methods. So, inheritance took place just for the code reuse purpose. An example of where this could be useful is with an employee record system. You could create a generic employee class with the states in action that are common to all employees. Then, more specific classes could be defined for salaried employed, commissioned employed, hourly employees. The generic class is also known as parent or super or base class, and specific classes are known as children or subclasses or derived classes. The concept of inheritance greatly enhances the ability to reuse as well as making design a much simpler and cleaner process. A subclass inherits all instance variables and methods from its superclass and also has its own variable and method. Fine. And one, the word that is used for inheritance is called extend. Well, there is another word which called implements, which is also used in inheritance, but I think we'll cover about that later on. As of now, let's focus on the word extends. Fine. And the purpose is to reuse the code. So this is a syntax. There is a class. And there could be any subclass name, like there could be a class name. So this is a subclass and it extends superclass name. So over here, like extend is a keyword, and like, so for example, there could be a class salaried employee extends employee. So employee is your superclass. And you know, in a real life example, what all things you can think that a salaried employee can inherit from the class employee? Well, I think it could be employee ID, employee name, and then employee address, employee phone number. So these are the properties that are common to each and every employee. Okay. So the employee class will have these, and the getters and setters, and also some methods to access these. Whereas when we talk about salaried employees, since it is extending it, and so therefore, it will get access to all of these data members if they have a like a proper access specifier. So even if the data members are private, but the getters and setters are public, so it will be able to access the data members through the getters and setters. Fine. And now the salaried employee class may contain an extra data member, which is salary, monthly salary. Now, monthly salary is a specific attribute related to the salaried employee. Similarly, there could be another subclass which says RE employees. So they must contain a data member called as RE salary. So now this RE salary will be specific to RE employee, and monthly salary will be specific to salaried employee. Okay? I hope so that's fine and it's very clear right now. Okay, so why the need of inheritance? When is a relationship exists between two classes, we use inheritance. For example, salaried employee is an employee. Similarly, RE employee is an employee. Or you can say dog is an animal, cat is an animal. So animal can be a base class and cat and dog can be subclasses. So the common features that all of these can share are, you know, like they are having four legs and two eyes, two ears, okay, and specific two particular class can be sounds that they make. So dog make a different sound of bark and cat make a different sound of meow. So these are like specific to the classes, but we do have some common attribute that can be inherited by cat and dog. Fine. In a parent classes term superclass and inherited classes term subclass, the keyword extend is used by subclass to inherit the feature of superclass, as we have seen. Inheritance is important since it leads to reusability of code. So now what is isA relationship? isA relationship describes inheritance relationship between object. If you talk something with the word isA, as we were saying, you know, like dog is an animal, cat is an animal, that is described with the keyword extends encoding. So we can say dog extends animal and cat extends animal, where dog, cat and animal are classes. Animal is a superclass and dog and cat is a subclass. Fine. So like this is the example we were talking about. There is a class animal and then we have a class mammal which extends animal. Then we have a class reptile which is also extending animal. And then we have a class dog. Now this class dog extends mammal class. So this is also possible. Fine. Now based on this example, in OOPS terms, the following terms are true. That is, animal is a superclass of mammal. Animal is also a superclass of reptile class. Mammal and reptile are subclasses of animal classes. Fine. And dog is a subclass of both mammal and animal. Why? Because dog extends mammal and mammal extends animal. Fine. Now if we consider is a relationship, we can say that mammal is an animal. Fine. Reptile is an animal. Again true. Dog is a mammal and hence dog is an animal as well. I hope you got the concept of is a relationship. Okay, so now this is an implementation of a dog class that is shown. Public class dog extends mammal. So you can see in this we have written a main method. Inside the main method, we have created an object of a class animal, which is A. Then we are also creating a object of a class mammal, which is M. And then we are creating a object of a class dog, which is D. And then we are using instance of operator to check whether, you know, like M is an animal or D is a mammal. So that's why we are printing M instance of animal. What do you think will be the result of this? Is M instance of animal? Well, yes, because M is an object of mammal and mammal extends animal. So this will give you true. Second statement says that D instance of mammal. So is D instance of mammal? Well, that is also true because dog extends mammal. Fine. After that, D instance of animal. Whether D is the instance of animal? Well, yes. Although dog don't directly extends animal, but dog does extends mammal and mammal does extends animal. So that's why D is the instance of animal. This will also give you true. All three statements will result in true. Okay, so far we have seen is a relationship. Now let us see has a relationship. Has a relationship are based on usage rather than inheritance. So has a relationship, although do not have any, you can say, direct link with inheritance. But in order to tell you the difference between the two, I'm going to cover has a relationship also. In other words, the class test has a test if test has a reference to instance of a class has a test. So has a test is a class and test is another class. Okay, so let's simplify it. Let's see this example. There is a class, public class, animal, fine. And then we have a class, horse. So over here, you can see we are having private animal object. So inside the class horse, we have created a private object of animal class. Although it is a reference, the object is not yet created. But since it is including a reference of animal class, so that's why horse and animal has a relationship. So we can say that horse has an animal. Fine. So this is the difference between isA and hasA. So I hope so you got the difference between the two. So let's move forward. What it is not possible using Java class inheritance? Well, let's see. Private members of superclass are not inherited by subclass and can only be indirectly accessed. Fine. Since private members cannot be inherited, since the scope of private is within the class, so it won't be inherited. And the only way to access those members are using public getters and setters. Fine. Then, members that have default accessibility in the superclass are also not inherited by subclass and other package, as these members are only accessible by their simple names in subclasses within the same package as superclass. So that means even in a case of default accessibility, since default members are only, the scope of default is only within a package. So if there is another package and there is a class that is inheriting a class of other class, data members won't be available for inheritance because the scope of default is only within the specific package. So only and only if the class is inheriting within a same package, then default will be available. But if it is outside the package, then it won't be available. Fine. Since constructor and initializer block are not member of the classes, so they cannot be inherited by subclass. So we have already studied constructor and initializer block cannot be inherited. Fine. A subclass can extend only one superclass. So yeah, that is a restriction Java has, that any class can only extend only and only one subclass. One superclass. Fine. So it cannot have multiple inheritance where it is extending multiple classes. Java does not support multiple inheritance. Fine. So let's move forward. So yeah, we have already studied about instance of, but let's check it again in detail. Basically, you check if an object is instance of a specific class or not. You normally use it when you have a reference parameter to an object that is of superclass of interface type and need to know the actual object has some other type. So we have already seen like what instance of does, and where it is commonly used is actually to check whether this particular class is an instance of some class or not, especially in case of super and subclass. When you want to check, you know, if that class is extending some other class, then you can check by using instance of. As in this example, there is a class animal and then there is a class main, and over here we are checking if animal is equals to new animal, and in if statement we are checking animal instance of animal. So this will give us true because definitely animal is instance of animal. But what if I checked if animal instance of object? What do you think will be the output? Well, it will give you true. Why? Because I told you object is a superclass of each and every class in Java. So, you know, it's like a big king class and every and each class is subtype of that class. So, each and every class implicitly extends that class. So, you never need to, you know, specifically write like public class animal extend object. It will be implicitly done. No matter you write. Okay, so if I am going to check animal instance of object, it will give me true. Fine. So let's move forward. Okay, now this is an interesting topic. This and super keyword. Well, before taking this and super keyword, I would like to quickly, write a code to show you how you can implement inheritance in your classes. So, to just create a very simple class, let's say I do have a class animal, fine, and then I have a class dog. Now, in order to extend class animal, I can use keyword extends and I can use animal, fine. So, this is a way we do extend classes, but over here we can see right now animal is not having anything. So, what is the purpose? Well, let's add something in animal. So, like animal could have legs. So, I'm entering int number of legs. Then int I can enter name, like every animal does have a name. Okay, string name. Fine. And then can have int number of eyes and so and so. There could be many features. Now since let me make them private following the concept of encapsulation. Our classes should be well encapsulated so that any subclass cannot directly access our data member and modify. Fine. So okay, it says the type animal is already defined. Let me check that. Okay guys, so I think there was a problem with the package name, so I've rectified it and created a new package. Okay, so we do have a class animal and then we have three private data members. Now let's create its getters and setters since we don't want to access them directly and we should not. We should rather use getters and setters always. So I'm going to create getters and setters. Yeah, we have created getters and setters. Let me just correct the sequence, although it doesn't matter, but just for readability purpose, I should write it upwards. Now, since my dog is extending animal, so my dog can access, getters and setters. Let's also create a method over here. The method is like public void make sound. Fine. And I'm writing over here animal sound. I hope so it looks good. I have just created a method make sound and saying animal sound. And now my dog extends animal. Fine. So let's make some attribute for the dog itself. I'm making like string voice or dog sound, or you can say simply sound. Fine. And let me make it private and include getters and setters for the variable sound. So yeah, I think we are good. So now let's create an object of dog class in our main method. So this is our main method. Let me create the object of dog class. Dog dog equals to new dog. I hope this looks good. Now let me try to see what all things are available to dog. So this will actually show you. Let me see if the private member of dog is available to it. So I have created like sound. You can see if I do this, this will give me an error. That's because if I simply like do sound, it will give me an error because it is a private member. So I cannot do that. But I have created like getter and setter for sound, so I can access it using that because getters and setters are public and I can access the public member in other class. So I'm making the sound as bark. Okay, I hope so this makes sense. Now let me try to access some of the methods of animal class to check whether it has really inherited anything or not. So let me call like set name. Yeah, so you can see all the methods of the animal class are available. All the setters are available because these are public and public methods can be inherited by the subclass. So yeah, I will use them to initialize or to store the values of my dog. So in a way you can see I'm reusing the code. I don't need to every time set the name and things for my dog every time. So that's why like this is a purpose of inheritance for reusing my things. So over here I'm going to put 4. Yeah, I think we are good. And I can also call the method make sound. Fine. So I hope so we are good. We can see how inheritance is getting used. But now, I do have this method make sound over here which says as animal sound. But what if, I want to actually print the sound of dog over here. But if I change this method, this will become specific to dog. This won't be specific to animal because sometime later I might like to make a cat class and extend animal. If I just change it over here, then my cat will also start the bark. But I don't want that. I want make sound to be, kind of reused, not reused, but rewritten for my dog class. So can I do that? Yes, I can do that. So let's do that. I'm just writing over here. Okay, firstly, let me just, call this and see what's the output. See, it's saying animal sound because currently this make sound is getting called, which is of an animal class because my dog is inheriting this method. Now let me create this method, or I would rather say override this method in the dog class. So this is called method overriding, in which we, make a method and we override it. So the method signature, the return type and everything has to be as it is what's there in the base class, and then you can change anything in the body. Over here, what I'm trying to do is I'm going to print bark. So I'm going to print simply sound. I have already stored what's in sound in my main class. Now see. So it is saying bark now. Why? Because when I'm calling make sound now in my main method, the make sound of dog, that is the overrided make sound method, is getting called instead of animal make sound. I hope that makes sense. It was a very simple example. So guys, although some part of this video or this presentation is left, I think that would take about another 10 minutes, but I don't want to stretch this video, so I'll cover that part in the next video. So thank you as of now. Stay connected and let's meet in the next video. Thank you.